Hello everyone. In the last lecture, we had seen how to design the knuckle joint. In detail we had seen. Now, here we are going to see the design procedure of the knuckle joint. Standard procedure which we have to follow so that we will get all the dimension. So this is the knuckle joint and we will start with first point. Calculate the diameter of the rod. So whatever this rod D, it is there, its diameter we have to find out. Then we know that the sigma T is equal to load upon area, and if you rearrange this, this T is equal to, you can use this equation by using which you can directly find out the diameter of the rod. Then second step, once you calculate this capital D, then we have to find out this the D1, that is the enlarged diameter of this rod. So that we use the directly empirical relation. What is the empirical relation? That capital D1 is equal to 1.1 times the diameter of the rod, which we found out already. The next, we have to find out the dimensions A and B. What is the A? It is the thickness of the fork end here it is, and the B is thickness of the this I end. That we have to find out. Again, this we are finding out from the empirical relation. So capital A is equal to 0.75 times the diameter of the rod, that is A is equal to 0.75 capital D, and this B is equal to 1.25 D. So these two constant A and B, that again we are finding out from the empirical relation. So now the next, we have to calculate the diameter of the pin. So whatever this pin is there, its diameter we have to find out, right? So this is the pin and its diameter D we have to find out, small d. And here we are considering both, either by the shear failure or by the bending failure, that we have to find out. And we can find out this diameter D by using the shear. We know the equation, that square root of twice P divided by pi tau. P is the load and the tau is the shear stress, allowable shear stress for the spin which they have given. So from that we can find out the small d. And second, we have to see the bending stress also. We know already sigma b is equal to 32 pi d cube into pi p by 2 into in bracket b by 4 plus a by 3. This is the equation by using which you can find out the value of again the d it is there. So this is what the diameter by using the shear, and from this by using the bending we find out the diameter, and we will get the two diameter. Out of that we always go for the larger diameter. So out of these two, which we will get the larger value, that we are taking as a final diameter of this pin. Then next, we have to find out the D0 and the D1. D1 is the diameter of the this pin head, and the D0, it is the diameter of this the fork end, outer diameter of the fork end which it is there. So this is the D0. These two again we are calculating from the empirical relation. So therefore D is equal to, D0 is equal to, that is this D0, it is equal to twice the diameter of the pin. Again I am repeating, it is twice the diameter of the pin, that is small d, twice d. Okay, but this D is what? Diameter of the pin. Then D1 is equal to, that is diameter of the pin head is equal to, it is 1.5 times the diameter of the pin. So this diameter D, it is there, it's 1.5 times. So D1 is equal to 1.5 small d. Now we found out all the dimension, that is D, capital D, D1, small d, D1, D0, A and the B. All the dimensions we had calculated. But whatever the dimensions we calculated, that is by considering the tensile stress. So here we have to verify whether it will sustain in crushing and the shear. So for that, we know that sigma t is equal to load upon the area, and sigma c, that is the crushing stress, is equal to load upon the area which it is adjusting to the crushing, and again shear stress tau is equal to load upon the area which it is resisting to the shear failure. As already we calculated the dimensions, that we will put in these three equations. This is the tensile, crushing and the shear. And here we will check whatever the stresses we will get after finalizing the dimension. These all three stresses, it should be within the limit. Whatever the allowable stress they are given, And if you are getting by calculating this less than that, then we can say that the design it is same. So if there is any you can say the stress it is exceeding, then again we have to redesign, modify the dimension, and again we have to verify. So here we are verifying in the tensile, in the crushing and the shear, and here all these three stresses it should be less than the allowable. Then again we will check the tensile, crushing and the shear in the fork. In the previous we had seen the stresses in the eye end, in this end, and now we will check in the fork end, right? So again we have to check in the tensile, sigma t is equal to load upon the area, already we are aware about this, then sigma c equal to, and then tau. So again this dimension a d 0 d, and here a d, and again a d 0 d, which already we calculated, right? So we will put all those value here once again, and we will check the sigma t, sigma c, and the tau, this value, and again all these value it should be less than the allowable stress. And if it is less than, then definitely we can say our design is safe, and then we can draw the final drawing. So this is the simple design procedure for the knuckle joint, by using which we can solve the different problems. I hope you have understood. Thank you. See you in next lecture.